So there's something called the 10,000 hour rule. You might have heard of it. And this was in the book Outliers. If you haven't read Outliers or listened to Outliers, I highly recommend this book. It's a great book. It's a small book. You can breeze right through it, by Malcolm Gladwell. And Malcolm points out in study after study is that the people in the top of their field aren't the best looking. We often think that they're the best looking or the smartest. They're not the most talented or the most connected. Those are the excuses that we all tell ourselves, right? We say, this is the reason why they're successful, because they have connections, this, that, the other. They've been in the business a long time, whatever. These are the excuses we tell ourselves for them being more successful than us. The truth is, though, that people that are at the very, 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 very top, the masters, have invested a lot of time in getting better at what they do. And the magic number is the 10,000 hour rule. The 10,000 hour rule is 10,000 hours of practice to become a master at anything. Any one of us sitting here, if we applied 10,000 hours of practice to any area of our business, would become absolute masters. Now you might say, well, that's a long time. 10,000 hours would be years of practice. I agree with you. But here's what I'm gonna ask you. How many of us have practiced at all, for any length of time, our listing presentation? A few of you have. But if you haven't, then what you should be doing is you should say to yourself, well, Jesus, not 10,000 hours, but maybe it should be 10 hours of practice. 10 hours would be a lot, right? Have you practiced for 2 hours your listing presentation, right? Have you called and practiced your scripts when people call you for a sign call or an ad call or an internet call? Are you practicing anything in your business to become a master at it? When you say to yourself, I want to make $300,000, $400,000, $500,000 a year, $200,000 a year, but you are refusing to practice, you're saying to yourself, I really don't want it. That's not really what I want. If I really wanted it, I'd act like I wanted it. And the way you act like you wanted it is practice, practice, practice.